Saying of China, her first vault, she's the first one up. They'll take two and average them.
And this is called a Cuervo vault. It's a handspring front with a half twist. Fairly good landing. Actually, they go into the handspring position, they make a half turn, and it's really a back tuck. It isn't a handspring front with a half, just the opposite. And it's worth a 10 in the code of points. Now, they have to do two different vaults, but this is the Cuervo. You see her make a half twist and flipping actually at the same time. They should make it as clean as possible, low on that landing actually, and that's going to cost her a few tenths of a point. A difficult vault. They should make the half twist right here. She was a little bit too much on the front of that horse. She was short. She makes the half twist. While she is twisting, she should have been a little cleaner on that, and that knee drop, that's going to be a big deduction.
22-year-old from Guangxi, the People's Republic of China, waiting for a score on the first vault.
And both vaults count. They do not take the better of two.
And there is Ludmila Tereshcheva, one of the immortals from the Soviet Union.
I saw her first in 1968 with two bows in her hair competing at the same time, and she's always been a classy lady. Inspired a lot of people.
Still waiting on the score for Chen Yongyan of the People's Republic of China's first vault. Mary Lou Retton will be next.
The Chinese have come a very long way on the vault. As we've mentioned throughout the competition, they have been weak on vault and floor exercise because of strength in the legs.
Mary Lou waiting. Well, like the American women, too, they've been behind the men's development, haven't they,
yes,
China?
Yes, they have. I think they are taking a little bit from the men, though, and starting to work a lot more on leg strength.
Well, this has been a familiar sight this week. The judges having a difficult time. The judging has been eminently fair, we might add. There's
yes.
been very little chauvinism practiced here, but there have been occasional delays, and this is one of them.
Lack of communication somewhere. Jackie Fai and Metlakova from Czechoslovakia, and they speak French to each other during the competition.
You see the athletes trying to keep their concentration in hand.
And we have seen in the past how that does affect some of the athletes.
9-5-5 for the first vault for Chen Yongyang. 9-5-5.
Her second vault will be a stretched layout Sukahara. It's worth a 9.9. She cannot get a 10 on it, even if she did it perfectly. The judging starts from a 9.9.
They will add the two vault figures together, divide by two, and that's her score, which is added to her preliminary score for her total. Sounds more complicated than it is.
Yes. That's why they have the computers down there.
Red light's still on. She has not been given the green light to go for her second vault.
The judges still look like they're talking about something. It's interesting.
A lot of track and field left here this evening. Of course, we have Edwin Moses going with that tremendous streak, one of the great streaks in all of sport, I guess. Evelyn Ashford in the 100-meter women's final. The women's volleyball team will be in action tonight. Trying to get into the gold medal round for that women's volleyball team. And
it's interesting to look down the floor exercise mat. It's actually 80 feet long. They have 80 feet to run. And that's only 3 feet wide, but that's all they need. They do put a tape measure down and they try to take their first step right at the exact time, at the right measuring point in the audience.
Well, the green light went on, then it went off. And the crowd is starting to clap. Whoosh!
Tell her to go.
I don't know whether it's something wrong with the equipment, but whatever it is, Chen Yongyang and the rest of these athletes have had a very bad time here in the opening moments of this competition. When you're ready to go, you're ready to go.
That's right. At least she could be down on the floor running back and forth.
9-4-0. They've changed her score from 9-5-5 to 9-4-0.
I think they should give her the extra tenth just for waiting.
What would be the cause of that,
Well,
Kathy?
Actually, I think they just had a problem with the scoreboard, punching it in right, the correct way.
Well, finally, Chen Yongyan will have her second ball.
And this is a layout-stretched Sukakara. Good position, much better ball. She should get a higher score. She has fair distance, not real long, not as much as we'll see with Rhett and Rosado. A good position in the air. Too long to wait.
Yes.
Let's take another look here. She has a good run. Hits right in the middle of that board, gets a good punch off. Arms look like they've been slightly. There's a pike. She should have been stretched just a little bit more. And that step will cause her a 10th. Here's another view. You can see her hands are still on the front of that horse. She should be more in the middle, and she's piking down a little bit too much. That should be more of a laid out position. There should be very little pike, if any.
This is the average.
All right, and her average now is 9-4. There's her 9-5-5 for her second ball, but her average is 9-4-7-5.